Hello, welcome to my Isengard playthrough, which we're dividing conquer one. Well, dividing conquer 1.2. Last time we took some small villages of Bregnas, whatever it's pronounced, Bregnas, and also Derwat. And Chief Lurs is there to, well, reinforce Saruman. Now, there's Prince Teodred, apparently.
It will be an
over
honor.
Here. Not sure how
you're
going to beat him because he has defense of 29 and 9 attack and 13 defense, so yeah, that's pretty bad.
No,
so, what do we have? I mean, what is Saruman himself
is
made
would?
Of? He's made of gods of Ortag, which are skilled against mounts and are really, really good. That's nice. What am I fighting here? I'm fighting a lot of defenders, which are not that great, but still annoying. The militia is actually worse. Gatling is going to be the hard one, though. The western defenders will be hard to kill, so let's get this party started, shall we? See you on the battlefield. Now, let me quickly check on my microphone is on. Yes, it is. It can happen sometimes. It's accidentally off. Alright, so what do we have? We have some raiders here, Uruk archers, and we have quite a crappy wall which we can fire through, so that's nice. Alright, Saruman himself is going to do most of the, well, Saruman himself is going to be most of the slugging work and basically get in there killing the most of them. These strikes with. How is my attack? Not that great, to be honest. I wish my attack was at least 12, that would be a lot better, but still, these are regular humans with really good armor. Basically, these guys are humans with Uruk armor, so not bad. Urukai were really good armored. They were not much better than normal orcs, but they were still better. I mean, keep in mind, compared to actual humans, they are pretty crappy. Alright, so let's go against all of this. So we're gonna fire against those, and we're not gonna fire against the Rohan bodyguard. I think it's a waste of arrows. It's a waste of arrow fire, if you ask me. So, yeah, we're gonna batter down the gate here before it burns down, and we can't take it. Wouldn't surprise me if it happens, so yeah.
Spearmen.
Like I said, it's pretty crappy towers, so that's good for me. At least I have that going for myself. And the arrow fire is going to be pretty good here because of the fact that the wall is so crappy, so we can really fire onto them. We won't be able to do too much damage because some of them are fairly armored, like the Western Defenders, but still. Some whittling down, you know, lowering their overall numbers by a slight amount, and of course doing some damage to the actual armor, I guess. I'm not sure how it goes. Do I first destroy the armor, like I hit the hit points and armor gets destroyed or something like that, or do I have to go through the armor and after that hit points get off? It's hard to know. I don't know, to be honest. If somebody knows, that could be interesting to figure that one out. Probably somewhere in the files. I'm not gonna find it out though. Rohan bodyguards. Yeah, they're losing some numbers, so that's nice. If you could kill some Rohan bodyguards, that'd be great, because they're gonna be impossible to kill. And again, they're not gonna be really that dangerous due to the fact they will not be able to charge against me that much, so that's nice. So that's really nice. You killed 5% of the army, so killed about, I don't know, 35. Yeah, that's about maybe 40. Yeah, maybe 40. Yeah. It's something. Not much, but it's something. I don't want to use my Urukai infantry. I only use them if I really need to. Because, well, they are really good units and I don't want to they won't come back. So I want to spare them for future battles. Now, this could be a mistake because, well, losing numbers could be a stupid thing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the ramp to break down another part of the wall. I know I have to repair it, but it doesn't really matter. It will really help me out if I can literally, well, if I can literally just pick up the ram and we're gonna blow up this. Well, it doesn't really matter, but I think we're gonna blow up this bubble wall and hit him from this side. Why? That way we can, well, literally. Oh, we have Force of Saruman. What does it do? Probably causes infighting and makes him run away and scared. That would be good. That'd be a nice little extra. Against his Western Defenders here. And fire against these militia over here. We killed about 12% without being anywhere near the enemy, so that's good. Let's go for these Western Defenders here, because they're near us. They're gonna charge me, but that charge is gonna be fairly ineffective. And we're gonna use Voice of Saruman. Cause infighting and probably massive drop in their morale, so that's nice.
The
really focusing upon this part of their army, so that's really nice to whittle down with arrow fire. We're not hitting our own men with it, in the meantime we're doing some decent amount of damage to their numbers, so it's nice. Break down the gate, we're gonna bring out our Uruk Raiders. And we're gonna hit them from this side with massive Uruk Raider action. Now we are hitting their general, which is gonna be... He's gonna do some damage, but he's not charging. He's gonna be running into a grind, which I am better at. And again, his defense is really high, but they're basically unlike me. They have about the same stats as me. And they're not charging, so... And I have more numbers. And I'm effective against mounts, so that's really helping out. That's helping out, what can I say. Okay, you can drop that right now. And now we're gonna march into against these militiamen over here. Same thing with you guys. Actually, where are you guys? I could let you guys hit from this side, that'd also be good, but we lost the building. Wow, that's actually impressive. We could put it on 2x speed because, well, not much is happening. How strong are my raiders again? It's hard to remember these stats. Yeah, it's pretty good. We'll do very well against the Eorling militia. That's pretty good. That's what they're mostly fighting here anyway, so... Don't do well against the Western defenders, but in the flank it might do something. I'm actually tempted to break another part of the wall and hit from this side, so we get more optimal flanks going on. Because we're not going to do much by pushing into this side again as well. So, yeah, it's hard to say. Yeah, I'm going to pick up this ram and start breaking this part down. You can always turn around if not needed, so, yeah. That is Saruman. Saruman's in the front. I don't like Saruman being in the front near the bodyguards. So I don't like that. So, yeah. Come on! Fight them, for God's sake! You're not doing anything, guys. Come on. You're not killing them. As far as I can see, you're not killing them. Yeah, stab him. There we go. Stab him. Start stabbing him a bit. This one of them should be dead by now. Actually, there isn't. Yeah, nothing is dying here. Over 40% of the army is dead. Okay, what's up with that? Apparently, they are killing something. Apparently, my raiders are doing most of the cutting work here. Not with my archers. Alright, let's be a bit... To destroy morale, we bring as much force as close to it. It will lower their morale by a lot. Hopefully. To be honest, this part is just hitting armor versus armor. Not much damage is here. So they're not really doing a lot of damage. Neither sides, really. Problem is, they're hitting my general all the time, which I'm not liking. If they were hitting my normal units, I wouldn't care too much, but they're hitting my general. So, yeah. We're doing quite some damage here against the Eorling militia. But then again, as soon as they're gonna hit the Westron, guys, it's gonna be a lot harder. Let's say that way. They're pushing me back, goddammit. Oh, actually, Saruman is pushed back, that's nice. Yeah, that's good. Saruman's not on the front anymore. That's nice. Kill the general so they can stop breaking. It won't matter too much because they're like literally at the square, but then again, doesn't matter too much. I kind of want to get my raiders around here. Actually, I'm going to try and get these guys at the back. So they will have no ability to get out. Get to the square. I'm going to try. I'm not sure I'm going to make it, but I'm going to try. So, yeah. Drop that thing. We're gonna try and get into the back of this. No, go through the wall. God, you idiots. Alright. We're gonna try and make it like that, where we see where we stand over here. Come on, get faster. Please go push in more and hopefully die. That would be great. Like, start stabbing with someone. There we go. Stab with a stab or something. I don't know. Do something of usefulness. No, we're starting to hit these Western defenders here, which isn't really helping out that much because they are clearly better than us. Come on. Pass most of them. There we go. Now we hit them in the back. It's going to be a lot harder for them to get into the square right now. And we're hitting them in the flank, so it's even doing more damage to that as well. That's nice. Yeah, I don't care about control of the castle. I just want to make sure they won't be able to get inside the castle that easy. Okay, get more numbers to this, just to have more morale damage to them. Even though they're gambling still alive, it's not going to matter too much, but you can think about it at least, right? You might be able to get over here as well with another force. We are surrounding them now. almost completely. Yeah, we have got a complete surround now. It's here still. They could push through here, technically, in real life. They could push through here. But there's a, and also here, because we're not surrounding them here, but that doesn't matter, because they can't get in the square. They are surrounding me here with some militiamen, but that's not going to last for too long. There's a full surround going on right now. They could easily push through here, but yeah, no matter. And we're going to take command of the castle. Yeah, we're going to hit them from this flank to make sure that they're completely surrounded. There's no way of retreat here for them. I'm actually tempted to send my Uruk-hai infantry against the general, because they have damage. Uruk-hai infantry at least has some... Actually, don't have much damage, never mind. The same as my Wolfgang defenders, really. Okay, get in there. They're breaking... They're fighting to the death, though. I don't like that. Yeah, I don't like that. But it doesn't matter. The morale is really... It's starting to really feel the damage here, so... No big deal. It's only the Rohan bodyguards left. Actually, get out of there. Yeah, they're almost all gone now. Surround them completely. I don't care about the castle. If I command it or not. I care about killing them all. It's better. Yeah, it's good. The old tank guards are beating them up slowly, but it's gonna take a while. Western defenders are gone, they're not gonna do anything anymore. Problem is the towers are gonna do a lot of damage to me due to the fact they're not dying. These generals are dying. Although, due to the flank of my Uruk-hai infantry, they're really taking a hit right now. Because now they're actually getting hit from multiple angles and get really cut up really fast. So I hope so. Come on, all of them must die. Oh yeah, try and run through, that will... Oh, there's Scanlan. There's Scanlan. Yeah, he was putting up a fight. We can't say he's not trying. Only three left. Among which is Scanlan. Oh, well, never mind. He's dead now. And that was his last guy, I believe. Yeah, that's it. No, there's still something left. No, he's dead anyway. I thought so. I saw another one die. That's pretty sure. Yeah, it's over. Alright, we didn't lose that much men. We killed Gambling, which is one of the major generals of Rohan. So that's, I was going to say Gondor, wow. Of Rohan, so that's good. We killed the most. All tanks, guards, they killed a few, but I think my raiders did the most job here. This raider group really pushed in and killed a lot. The second raider group was a really good flying and really made the battle go faster. Because that, if I didn't put my other units this way, it would have made the battle so much longer. Also, March is pretty good, so that's nice. Alright, see you guys back on the campaign map. Now, with the Ant War... Well, is it the Ant... No, what am I saying? It's the Foldberg. With the Foldberg under my command, I have my first... Major... well, not really that much. I have my first... Palamingus. So yeah, these actually are pretty good. Yeah, so I have my first... Major town of Rohan, even though it's not really major, but hey, it's no town of Rohan, here. I guess. Now, I am tempted to actually launch forward to go after Theodred, because Theodred is, well, something that needs to die. So let me see, look at ancients. So I have...
At your service.
I have you, Grima. Let's go talk to Theodred.
We shall listen to your proposal, but do not...
Yeah, I thought so. Give me map. No. Map formation, and map formation, and you look at my vassal. That's good to get map formation.
Never. Do you think us foolish and meek?
We understand. Now, this is the real reason why I wanted to go there. I want to see what Theodred had. Now, he has cavalry, he has scouts, and he has yielding the militia. Which means he will die. I just want to go after and kill him. Because he needs to die really fast. And I have my Gods of War tank, which should be able to kill Theodred. Although,
we destroyed the enemy!
Where did he run to? Yes. Where did he run to? Now, I could go after the Hornburg, but I know the Hornburg is going to have massive militia. So, I need to find Theodred. I think he went to the to Edoras. Probably. That's where King Theodred should be, though. So, I'm not sure where he's where he's hiding.
At once.
It's hard to say, really.
Continuing tomorrow.
But I can manage for now. The bridge near Edoras is a really important thing, which I will abuse. You will see when I use it. You will see why it's very important. Now, what is my enemy and what is mine? So this is Okay, so this is apparently, according to this, this is Rebel, okay? This is Anadwaite, I believe. Yeah, that's Anadwaite. Anadwaite lands. So we're gonna leave you behind. And you will go to the Rebel lands.
We have completed.
Yeah, this is Anadwaite. We're not gonna fight Anadwaite yet. Why? Anadwaite's a pain in the ass to fight and will cost too much resource for me to deal with. Now we need to figure out what we can build of an army, because we need men. We need many, many men. And it doesn't matter what we get, we just need bodies. Snaga, anything needs to be thrown into this, just for pure bodies. Now, I know the orc, first repair, and of course, Shrine of Melkor, dirt paths, and slate pads, blah, blah, blah. Now, I know at turn, I think it's 50 or 40, we need to be prepared for the Ents. The Ents will be a pain. We need to have an army in Isengard to defend it. Because if not, we are dead. I mean, literally, we are dead. Because Isengard, losing Isengard is basically a death sentence.
No,
now, we will siege
here.
The Holmberg in case that Prince Theodore decides to attack me.
Want?
I should be safe.
Ready for fight.
Should have to hold out against him. If he comes alone. If he doesn't, well, I'll have to deal with Erkenbrand, his archers, and with him himself. That's the only difference I'll have. Actually, it would be better if I don't have to deal with all the bloody militia that's going to be inside it, because it's going to be a mass amount of it. You'll see. Does this give anything, really? It doesn't give anything. That's kind of weird. Huh. Oh well, let's end the turn and see what happens, shall we? Ah, there is Captain Tritwolf, whatever you pronounce that. Now, we're gonna see what is inside. They're sending small forces out, that's good. It's good and bad. Why? Small forces means that they're hard to control, but also means I need less forces to, well, kill them. It means I can wipe them out and don't have much. Now, I'm gonna take you, and I wanna see... I will not do that. It's too far off, really. Now, equipment report. Yes, good. Lutz will reinforce this. But first, I will check with Sodom or something.
Kill them all!
I thought so. There's gonna be a lot of westerns here. It was predicted. We will draw from battle. And what do we have here? Gustold. Yeah, okay. End of turn report. Yep, okay. You will march forward towards the rebel lands.
You I have are nothing a to rebel. Say to you, scum.
Drudane hunters. Huh. The Drudane. The Drudane are basically... Yeah. Drudane are basically dwarf-like, guys. They're like dwarves. Pretty much. I don't know what exactly they are. I mean, what I know what they are, but yeah. It's hard to... figure it out. Now, what are these guys? They're Uruk-hai bodyguard. Okay, those guys are good, but they're not amazing. You will be the guardian of all tank. You'll be the guy that's gonna defend all tank against whatever.
No sleeping here.
That's gonna come. You'll go to Foldberg, protect it for now. Lurtz will go to Saruman. Actually, Lurtz will go after Captain Tritwolf. And I'm tempted. I'm tempted to actually withdraw Saruman, lift the siege.
Pull back! We must pull back!
Why? That's actually didn't expect that. But the thing about it is though, I tried to get Erkenbrand outside. You saw Erkenbrand was actually willing to join that. So if I got that, but now I can Prince Theodred. So that's also really good. Now I could do a night attack. I don't have to deal with Prince Theodred. But I'm going to deal with Prince Theodred because I want him gone. Because I have a feeling next turn they were all going to gang up on me. Which would have been a massive battle, which I don't want to. This battle is a lot easier too. They have scouts. I don't like scouts. They're really crappy. Okay, never mind. Alright, see you on the battlefield. Okay, start blooming. Now, Blooming Screen actually was about the Uruk-hai actually pillaging... the Lands of Rohan, which is actually kind of fitting here. Alright, we're gonna put my guys over here. Why? I can put my archers maybe in a good position where I can do some damage with our air fire. Also, we can take a good, like I said, we can take a good high ground. I'm not sure where they're gonna hide though, but they're gonna hide somewhere. Yeah, it seems like I'm gonna have to fight them into this area. Wait, these guys are scouts as well? Huh, what do you know? These guys are actually scouts. Oh well, it doesn't matter. They're running backwards already. Good. Good start. Good start. Well, I guess I have to chase them down for 5 million years in a row. Alright. Could you please get your army over here so I can kill it? But yeah. Okay, can I get my guys over here? No, I can't. Okay, so I have to basically go down here and... Let me guess, I have to go all the way around now. Yeah, of course. Yeah, makes sense. Okay. Makes some sense, really. You guys were not skirmish, by the way. And you guys will just make a line right now. Why? Because there's no way they're gonna fight me at the moment. They're not gonna come for me, I have to go for them. Which is gonna take forever, but yeah. And I'm actually tempted to pause until that moment, so see you guys in the... Alright, we are back. So the enemy decided to, I don't know, do something. And my frames decided to basically crawl to a halt, which is also a thing. As you can see right now, I'm not sure what's up with that. We were fine before, now we're having this. Alright. Yeah, you can see this is clearly what the fuck is going on. We were fine before, now we're this. What's up with this? I wanna know. What's up with this? What's causing this? We seem to be a bit better, but still as shit as hell. Come on, this is ridiculous. We were fine before, now it's complete utter trash here. Alright, we're gonna move our guys up more forward, because I thought they were gonna charge me, but they didn't. Ugh, unbelievable. Gonna make it to make a very compact thing. Now keep in mind this is very dangerous because compact also means damage potential could be high from the cavalry. And again, these are regular scouts, so they're not gonna do too much. And I wanna know what the fuck's up with this. See you guys again in a bit. Alright, so I look for the fix, but there is no fix at all for this frame rate. I'm not sure what's even causing it though, by the way. Yeah, as you can see, this is terrible frame rate. Wow, this is just like abysmal tier. Now, we are getting charged, which I'm kind of finding really weird. So we're gonna send in our Urukai infantry against these scouts. And our raiders will stay in the back, while my archers are gonna stay in the back as well for this one. Because, well, we don't want to get charged by them. But I feel like the scouts actually go in my archers, so... Kind of interesting about this one. Actually, let's let my archers fire against their scouts a bit, so they will be whittled down by arrow fire. And actually, most of my provoke Teotrit to actually charge me, which will be great. Yeah, this frame rate is completely trashed here. It's abysmal. I'm actually not even willing to waste arrows on these things because they're so crappy in stats. And I wanna know what's causing this fucking frame rate! Need to restart or something? What the hell? Great, great, one of those things. I can't do it because I haven't saved. So yeah, I can't do it really. Fight me! Fight me against the gods of all tank. Get blocked by them. Okay, by the way, we're gonna... So Trita is moving. Somewhere. Let's get my archers in position there. Get in there. Come on, charge, charge. Lock them. There we go, they're locked. Now they're gonna try and go melee. There we go, they're gonna go melee now. Not sure where Theodore is going, but he's going somewhere. And our frame rate seems to have fixed. Yay, I can move smoothly. That was weird. Alright, never mind. I'm not gonna question why it was that. I'm just gonna say, like, it happened. Nothing happened. Nothing special. We're gonna save the voice of Saruman against Theodred. Also, why am I losing men against those? I don't even understand that. Alright, let's get my archers over here. They can even flank those guys if they want to. Actually, you guys will flank that. So if they run away, they will not get away. Actually, they're running away, but yeah, too late now. Too late for me to react to it right now. Got raiders get in here as well. Gonna go a little bit faster. We're not gonna make it too fast, so we could react against the scouts. Yeah, as you can see, the scouts are willing to do some stuff here. Mm-hmm. Okay. Get the gods of all time closer. Mm-hmm. There we go. Get them blocked by us. Get them blocked by us now. These guys are so shitty in stat, they shouldn't be able to do anything. Yet somehow they're killing my men. A little bit. See, they kill no matter what. How? Victory will be ours. Another cavalry, but they shouldn't be able to do this at all, actually.
The enemy are badly bloodied.
That's only the first army. I want to have the actual Teodoret army that I went on. Now, should I fire against the infantry and against the scouts, I guess? Teodoret is going to be a waste of arrow fire, if you ask me. He has so much armor, we aren't going to do anything against him. Yeah. I think I have to set my old tank guards against him in order to be efficient. Ignore the scout. Oh, wait. What are they doing? Okay. They're doing something. Get the archers up to a higher location. Like, they have more elevation away. Doesn't matter if they're spread out. We don't get them that good arrow volleys, but... Actually, let's get them a bit spread out like this. There we go. Everyone, get in position. Little Gradus, get in here to protect this. They're Uruk-hai Raiders. I know, Uruks and Uruk-hai are not the same. Uruks are from Mordor, Uruk-hai are from Isengard. There's a clear difference between Uruk-hai and Uruks. Uruks are technically stronger, I believe, as well. Because they're the original ones. They're the original design. But Saruman perfected it, so it has some merit to it, I guess. We want Saruman against him. Basically, we want Saruman against Rohan's bodyguard. We're gonna turn him a little bit around. We need to lock him. Not sure where they're going, but the Unilingus militia are gonna go on a collision course with my guard of all time, it seems. Oh no, you don't. You're not escaping me at all. Get over here. Go for him! Go for him, Saruman! Kill him! You guys, go after this. They're actually escaping, what the hell? Okay, Uruk-hai infantry is here. Get my Uruk-hai raiders in here as well. Use the will of voice of Saruman. Go to Uruk-hai militia. The scouts have taken a massive damage. Taken a massive beating. Uruk-hai militia are taking a beating right now. The Rohan bodyguards are still holding strong though. The militiamen are taking a beating with archers. Actually, fight against the scouts here. In a bit. I'm actually tempted to fight against this, but it would kill more of my own men than anything else. Fight against the scouts. Make sure that they get whittled down before they do anything. The militiamen are taking a beating from my Uruk-hai fighting Uruk-hai. They can do some charging here, which is gonna hurt, but shouldn't hurt that much. Their charge broken from arrow fire, which says enough already. Also, they were locked by Uruk-hai infantry, so... They're taking a beating here. They are killing some of my raiders, but I don't really care too much about my raiders, to be honest. We need to lock the Uruk-hai bodyguards. Okay, they're gone. Get the militiamen out. Come on, kill them off. You go after the... Keep surround the bodyguards. We must make sure the bodyguards surround it. Because I'm a broken through the militiamen. If we can break through the militiamen, that'd be great. Because that means we can set our infantry, our Uruk-hai infantry, after the bodyguard. That will do a lot of damage. Because then we can literally box them in. There we go. Let them escape. Those three are not going to do anything. They might stab one of my guys. Actually, they got killed anyway. So we need to get a complete surround on them. There we go, we should get a complete surround and a decent charge against the bodyguard. Theodred. Come on, get more surround on him. Where's Theodred himself? There he is, he's surrounded. He's the one we need to kill, the rest I don't care about, just him. He's trying to do an escape, running through my infantry. Which is not going to go too well for him, I'm pretty sure. He's killing some infantry though. Look at this. He's still trying to make an escape for it, and he's capable of it. He's going to make it, isn't he? Come on, need to make another surround. Come on. Come on, need to make another surround so they every time they're locked. No, continue, continue! Catch him! No, he's going to get away. Can he get away? How much? Yeah, he can get away. He's a reinforcing army. He can get away if he wants to. Damn it! That's what you get with... You can't chase him down, though. Yeah, let's end the battle here, shall we? He survived. We didn't lose much. Theodore's army has been beaten, which wasn't really worth it. If Theodore died, this would have been worth it, but he didn't. So this was not worth it. I will end the episode here. Hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a comment, give it a subscribe, and thank you for watching, and see you guys next time. See you then. Bye.